Hey everybody, welcome back to the channel. I am Britt, creator of The Style Shaker, your guide to cleaner, greener beauty, skincare, and more. I try products out for you and share my honest reviews so you know what to buy. More importantly, what not to buy. And today I am back with a review for the Merit Minimalist Perfecting Complexion Foundation and Concealer Stick. It's a lot. It's a big product title. So it's a new launch and I wanted to give it a try for you. So if you want to hear more about this or if you're in the market for a foundation slash concealer slash everything stick, stick around. Ooh, stick around, get it? No pun intended. Let's get into it. Okay, I have this in shade Bisque, $38. There are 20 shades available for this guy. It's a pretty full spectrum range. Claims to be an all-over coverage, so you can make small edits only where you need them. Lightweight hydrating formula, wears throughout the day without settling into fine lines. Claims to have buildable light to medium coverage. Is cruelty-free, vegan. The product component was made from 43% recycled plastic, and it comes in their packaging that is either recyclable, usable, or compostable. So I do appreciate that they thought that through, but there's still net new plastic in this. So if you guys have been watching, you know I'm not really big into that plastic. Well, I wish they were a little bit better there. Let's just get into the scorecard. The scorecard is the foundation of every review here. It keeps things as objective as possible. If you like seeing these honest reviews and you want to see more of them, don't forget to like and subscribe to the channel so you don't miss anything as it comes through. There are 5 quick questions. The first one's always about ingredients. So how do the ingredients look? This is my fun disclaimer. Not a cosmetic chemist, not a dermatologist. Also not big into fear-mongering and villainizing ingredients, so you're not gonna find that here. But I do dive a bit deeper back on the site. There is a link to the scorecard post below if you want to check it out. On the videos, I just try and give a high-level review and tell you whether or not I see red flags. I saw a couple, well, I basically saw one red flag. It's a bit more personal. It's called dimethicone. You've heard me talk about it if you follow the channel. This is not a bad ingredient. It just breaks my skin out, so I can't use it a lot. There's also something in here called BHT. It gets a bad rap. Both of these are towards the mid to end of the ingredient list. It's a preservative and antioxidant that's used to stabilize and prevent oxidation. I have a link if you want to kind of dive in there and geek out back on the post. I'm not really concerned about that. I'm more concerned about dimethicone because it's higher on the list and it would make me break out. So overall, it looked pretty good. How is coverage? Claim here is that it's buildable light to medium coverage, right? So I think that it followed through on the light to medium coverage claim. It was very, very silky going across the skin. It really did glide across and it felt very lightweight too. I will tell you from my experience, I really liked putting on a tinted SPF before. I used this for touch-ups on top to even out the skin tone, to maybe spot treat, a little bit of concealing. So I really liked having that base along with some other hydration and it really gave me a better coverage there. It gave me a better finish. So I should probably just talk about finish, but first I have to give you the overall coverage score. I got a 4 out of 5 on the scorecard. Okay, so next, finish, like I've been saying, tricky. One layer of this proved to give pretty good finish in the smaller areas that I used it. So if I was using it to conceal, I was using it as spot treatment, or just a couple of dabs on the skin to even things out, I think that gave me more of a natural skin looks like skin finish. It's when I built things up, which is what I wanted to do for concealer because I wanted more concealing. Hello. When I started to build it up, I preferred pressing things in with my fingers. Using a kabuki and using a sponge lifted, created streaks and stuff for me, so I didn't like that application. When I built it up, that's when I saw things starting to settle a bit and crease. I would say it definitely was creasing more under the eye. And at first I saw it settling on top of the larger surface areas like the skin and the forehead. I kept pressing it in. I wanted to give it a minute because sometimes these things improve with time. But quick spot treatments, so like if I had a dot here or some like little redness that I needed to judge, if I would do that and press it in, it did a very nice job there. It was just the larger surface areas that gave me kind of an unnatural finish. Something else I want to note, my skin has really been much, much better. It's not as dry as it was, but it's still combination skin, and I found that I had to really moisturize. A light moisturizer on top of skin to prep it was not enough for me. I needed to get deep into the moisturizer. It's not going to be that way for everybody, but if you have skin like mine, then that's something you might want to try. It could help you out. The thing is, from far away, it looked great. But when I got up close with my magnification mirrors, which maybe I should get rid of, but they really do help with these reviews, or in natural light, which is when people are gonna see it, it was good coverage, it evened out. It's just that finish was a little strange. There was a little bit of sitting on top for me, and a little bit of texture increasing where I just didn't want it. Overall score there was a 3 out of 5. The next question is, does it last? The claim is that it wears throughout the day without settling into fine lines. No, it settled into fine lines, sorry, but it did. Sorry, kind of not sorry, but that was just my skin. That could be different for somebody else's experience. And then overall lasting, it lasted elsewhere on the face. This is not the thing that just slides off your face by the end of the day. The finish was not wonderful by the end of the day, but it wasn't terrible. It was just that I saw some sitting on top, a little bit of feathering. But I still think for staying power, it actually hung on very well. Overall score there was a 4 out of 5. And the final question here, shade range, is it inclusive? I think the 20 shades are great in terms of number, in terms of what they actually look like, which is also taken into account here. I do think, like I mentioned, it's a broad range of shades and the brand will help you shade match, so that's really nice too. The overall score here was a 15 out of 20 on the scorecard. And now it's time for my final verdict. $1 million question, would I buy this again? I would probably not buy this again, and I'll tell you why. Mainly because I found the finish to not be super duper wonderful. While I liked the spot treatment, I can get that spot treatment from a concealer. A lot of what I liked in this, I like better in just concealer. Would I use this as a foundation? Probably not. I also wish that I could put the cap on this and not hit the product every time. So that's what I think. What do you think about this Merit Minimalist Stick? Would you try it? Have you tried it? Do you love it? Do you like the multi-stick part of it? I'd love to know your opinion. Definitely leave it in the comments below. And that's all I have for today. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, make sure you like the video and subscribe to the channel. I'll see you right back here real soon. Until then,